Joining us this week, it's been far too long, former Democratic congressional candidate and Senate President Pro Tem Richard Romero. Good to see you back here. You need to be back here more often. Editor-in-Chief, the New Mexico Law Review, Sophie Martin returns, former New Mexico House Republican whip and former thorn in Richard's side, Dan Foley. Could be current thorn, you never know. And U.S. Commerce Department official under George W. Bush, Jamie Estrada, he's back too. As such, Jamie, let's start with you here. Are we looking at the right places and the right case studies to gauge job creation in New Mexico? Because things seem to have come to a bit of a standstill. I want to ask you straight up, are you seeing anything out of this administration that gives you a sense that there's a plan, at the very least, for jobs and for growth here in New Mexico?
I'm encouraged by what the administration is doing with regard to tax reform. I saw, you know, that Secretary Clifford came out with another iteration of his proposal that they're going to take to the legislature this coming January that says, hey, we're going to try to do something about the gross receipts tax. We're going to try to do something for specifically for those small businesses, right? Mm-hmm. We're going to do something about pyramiding. We're going to do these variety of things that I think would make us more competitive. Mm-hmm. But that's one side of it, right? That's the environment, creating the environment mm-hmm. for job creation in New Mexico, and that's got to be done. But I think we're still caught up in the old, you know, ideas of economic development. Mm. You know, a lot of the states are doing some pretty innovative things. I'm not sure that New Mexico has been, you know, caught the trend.
I want to ask everybody at the table to consider what my man Jamie just said right there, because I'm hearing the same thing, Dan. Things don't sound creative. There's no creative problem solving, no creative ideas, no creative identification of where our strengths are, where we need to do work, besides upping education and such. So same question, you know, are we on track here or what's going on? Because we've got some downturns here.
There's no track to be on. That's the problem, Gene. You look at the amount of people in the state that work for the government. How do you have innovation? What do you want? How are you attracting folks? We are so heavily dependent on the labs, the military bases, state government, county government, city government. In my opinion, when you have that huge dependency on government, it stifles creativity. Mm-hmm. You don't have to do stuff. What are you waiting for? You're waiting to elect the next person to go to Washington and bring back more money. Mm-hmm. You're waiting for the government to give you more money in the way of a job.
So let me ask you this on that note. Why do we continue to get hung up on things like tax cuts and nibbling at the edges for these things?
Well, because we have to do something to help the few that are here. We have to do something to try to bring the peripheral stuff that we can. You know, you got to look at trying to bring in the things that we have a workforce for, whether it's, you know, people got on me when I was in the legislature, Gene, about call centers. Mm-hmm. You know, what are we going after call centers for? Call centers, they're low-paying jobs. They don't help. But my dad used to have a saying. He said, the best time to get a good job is to have a bad job. It's not to be unemployed. Mm-hmm. And we got to start somewhere. We don't have this high-tech, you know, we're not Silicon Valley, we're not Los Angeles, we're not New York, we're not Chicago. We have a different workforce in this state. And I think that this is not something that we can change overnight. We got to take baby steps, we got to put people to work.
Sophie, you're on the front edge of a lot of technology.
Well, I have to jump on something that Dan just said and disagree with an aspect of that. I mean, there are several things that I disagree with, but one is this. The federal labs in the state of New Mexico have always been generators of innovation.
I agree.
For our state. And jobs. And the cluster of small businesses that either spin out of the labs or come here to be near those labs have been real boons to our economy. We have an extraordinarily creative work class mm-hmm. workforce working for the federal government here in New Mexico. And I think that to the extent that the labs are also under fire because we are seeing cuts coming from the feds, that has a tendency, I believe, to stifle creativity. When you're concerned about your job, when you're concerned you're not going to be able to keep it. Mm-hmm. I look to our senators, our congresspeople, to try to generate additional funds for Sandia and Los Alamos. I think that is a real source of
Let me challenge you on something, however, Sophie. Aren't you talking in 1990s era terms, like looking for the labs to be the savior, so to speak? Aren't we? Shouldn't we be pushing past that at this point?
What happens in an environment in which the labs mm-hmm. Encourage technology commercialization is that it doesn't all stay on campus. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm.
Like, it doesn't stay in New Mexico. That's the problem.
Okay, I think that's a good point.
The jobs you're talking about, the problem is when they do spin off, they require the feds to hire them to do the work. They're not spinning off and creating a standalone company like
I think the bigger issue is that we don't have a great deal of venture capital here. We have some venture capital, but often VC firms will say to a promising company that's spinning out of Los Alamos, we want you here near us in Northern California.
Yes.
And that's a piece that we're missing.
From your point of view, Richard, you've been in so many committee hearings, you've heard all this before, endlessly. Is there a common thread that you would like to see broken in our approach, our thought process?
Well, we've talked about reducing taxes. Mm-hmm. We did. We passed a huge tax cut, personal income tax. Mm-hmm. We were told by Republicans at the time that if we did this, people would just come out here.
And this was under Governor Richardson.
Absolutely. Yep. I mean, we are now lower than Arizona, Utah, and Colorado. Mm-hmm. Of course, Texas doesn't have one, but they have higher taxes in other areas. Mm-hmm. The Rio Grande Foundation doing away with the right to work law. I mean, that's nonsense. It's kind of like Gary Johnson's old ideas that used to come out like, I can build 3 schools for the price of 2 if we do away with the prevailing wage act and the Little Davis-Bacon Act.
I
say that if Gary Johnson had the opportunity, he'd still build 2 and he'd profit the other.
Why
school.
Is profit
because,
a bad word, Richard?
Well, it's not a bad word,
okay.
But I'm just telling you that's what he would do. Because,
but that's why those companies
because
are moving
he's not
here.
Being truthful about it. Why would someone want to do away with a law that keeps wages up? Because businesses surely won't. For capitalism to survive, you actually need to take advantage of the tax laws, manipulate tax laws, mm-hmm. take advantage of labor, try to get people to work for as little as you can, and then rape the environment if you have to. I mean, take advantage. I mean, in other words, do what you can mm-hmm. with as little as you have to mm-hmm. bring back to the table mm-hmm. in terms of the environment. And that's how you make a profit.
So who is attracted to that environment? What kind of business,
well, I think
what
our business,
kind of company, what kind of CEO? Who would be attracted to that?
I think
here?
Our business climate is very friendly. We want businesses here. We try to do whatever they want. We pass laws that give them breaks in terms of any taxes that they think are bad.
Too.
Well, it is, especially if they leave us flat.
Well, we start picking winners. We're picking winners and losers.
But a big problem that we have here is our water.
Huge problem.
It's huge. I mean, people see that, and they just back away. I mean, it's just something that turns them off. The other thing is, I think our political climate mm-hmm. is tough. The instability, I think, that, mm-hmm. that politicians and their policies and the fighting that goes on, I think, is not good for our economy.
I mean, I want to retouch back with Sophie's mm-hmm. point, because you make a good point. There are some technology signs here of potential flowering that has been very exciting.
Well, I think that has
very,
a real track
exciting.
Record yes. is ongoing. Do you mm-hmm. know what I mean? So mm-hmm. we can point to technology coming out of the labs and say that has been going on for a long time. Mm-hmm. That is a relatively stable source, mm-hmm. which is a crazy thing to say, of innovation. But what we're seeing on the national level is mm-hmm. that as the federal government cuts taxes to unprecedentedly low levels, as mm-hmm. they cut taxes, as they cut investment, as they cut money going to infrastructure, but also to innovation, we're not seeing the stability in our lab workforce that we saw at one time.
Mm-hmm. I've got to say something, because I think that New Mexico could really be the capital of startups, mm-hmm. but we're not. We don't nurture them.
We have a history of running them out. Ask Bill Gates.
Exactly. We don't nurture them. And I think we have this obsession with, well, you know what, we don't have any Fortune 500 companies here. We don't have
sure.
that level.
Yep.
So let's figure out how to nurture those to become one of them one day.
But you know what happens, Jamie? I've been around economic development circles for a long time. Here's what everyone says. Oh, those guys, they're just onesie twosies. They're just onesie twosies. They're not going to hire a bunch of people, not knowing that those are the Bill Gates of the world,
well,
the onesie twosies.
Right.
You know, so
but
right.
we have hundreds of 25-person startups.
Right,
that's a tremendous amount of high-wage-paying jobs. Mm-hmm. Many of them are service jobs because they're not
sure.
In manufacturing or whatever, they're requiring high-skilled, high labor.
We're under a minute. I just want to throw another thing out. You guys may or may not be aware of Curt Schilling, ex-baseball player, just lost $50 million in personal money in a gaming company that everybody thought was going to be the next big thing. It's a risk environment, Dan.
It is a risk environment. But
who's going to roll the dice like that here?
Government.
Well, that's right. That's right. He wanted limited government. He didn't want any handouts.
Yeah, but it's his money. I mean, The problem is this. Mm-hmm. Is that we talk about all these spinoffs from the labs, and we do have some. They do good, but they're dependent on the labs buying back their technology. So it's the self-fulfilling prophecy. I mean, they're not out there in the private sector. There's very few of them, Jamie. I mean, this, we have not had huge corporations in this state that have spun off out of Los Alamos that aren't dependent on government dollars keeping them going, whether it's selling back to the DOD, the Department of Energy, or somebody like that. And I think that hurts us because we're so dependent on that. I think at the end of the day, the problem is this state has to decide we need to stop picking winners and losers. The money we threw at Schott Solar, why? There's 50 other solar companies out there. Why did we pick one company to have it?
They're international. They had a track record. They had a very
quick. But everybody knew where that was going.
No, I would disagree with that. Everyone did not know where
everybody,
that was going.
Gene, I'll tell you right now, I was in the committee meetings, and we were getting the reports that are telling us China's doing this, and China's doing it for less than you can do it today.
That's fair.
So we did know that. Okay. And so I think at the end of the day, the jobs in New Mexico is, I think that, you know, we have to realize we're a unique state. Mm-hmm. The water is a huge issue in this state. It's an issue in Arizona. Mm-hmm. It's an issue in parts of California. It's an issue in the entire Western United States. Mm-hmm. But I think that what we have is we've got to figure out how to get a workforce up and going. I'll close by telling you this. I had an employer in my district that had 110 openings, and they started out at $24 an hour. He interviewed 250 people down in Chavez County. Of the 100 that he hired, 5 passed the drug test.
Wow.
After he hired those 5, after the first payday, 1 came back to work. Ooh. That's the problem in New Mexico that we have to figure out how to address this work development in the state.
Well said. After the break, conservative commentator Jonah Goldberg.